Welcome to the 2020 Maltz Jupiter Theater Goldner Conservatory of Performing Arts Virtual Award Celebration. Proudly sponsored by honorary producer, the BB Foundation, BB and Joe Ricardo. Shining star sponsors, Roberta and Harvey Golub, Dr. James H. Howenstein, Marty and Bob Sachs. Rising star sponsor, the Clark Family Private Foundation. Wish Upon a Star sponsors, Paul and Sandra Goldner, and Jackie Cato and Howard Smith. Please welcome the Maltz Jupiter Theater's Goldner Conservatory of Performing Arts, Director of Education, Julie Rowe.
I'm so happy to be here with all of you today. Thank you so much for spending time with us in celebration of our students. Arts education is a process. It's not an end game, but rather what happens along the way. Did we grow? Have we learned? Have we improved? Those are the benchmarks of excellence in education. Growth, experience, steps forward. Education is also ongoing. Artistry means being a constant student of life. That is what we instill in our students. Live a self-examined life so that you may be the best person you can possibly be in whatever path you choose. By doing so, you will serve yourself and your community to your fullest potential. That is excellence. Now, let the awards begin. Our first award is the Maltz Jupiter Theater Guild Award. This award is presented to a student who has shown commitment, determination, and marked improvement in any one discipline at the conservatory. It is given to a student who has best exemplified the hard work needed to progress within their talents.
The Maltz Jupiter Theater Guild Award for Outstanding Improvement, Gary Bledsoe.
Thank the Maltz Jupiter Theater for presenting to me this award. It shows me that you can do anything if you put your mind to it and stay persistent. First of all, I want to thank my guitar teacher, Miss Leah, for putting so much time and effort in me every Saturday. And I just really want to thank her for helping me become the guitar player I am today. Second, I really want to thank my parents for encouraging me and staying with me on this long journey and helping me with my guitar. And I just want to thank the Maltz Jupiter Theater for giving me a safe and really nice place to learn.
Our next award is the Jody Ann Saltzman Memorial Award for Most Spirited. This award is given to the individual in the conservatory who is always willing to give of themselves to the moment. The student continues to pursue their love of the performing arts with passion and enthusiasm.
The Jody Ann Saltzman Memorial Award, Jalen Corkin.
Hi, I'm Jalen Corkin, and I'm honored to be receiving this year's award for being the most spirited. And I just wanted to say thank you. I'm very grateful for all of my mentors, family, and friends that have supported me in the theater. I wouldn't be here today if you guys weren't there to push me to be the best I could be. The Maltz Jupiter Theater Conservatory of Performing Arts has been home to many of the best experiences in my life. Today I want to talk about my many aha moments that I've had at the Maltz. The first aha moment I had was when I had stepped onto the Maltz Jupiter Theater stage for the very first time. The feeling of excitement and happiness came over me. I knew this is where I was meant to be. Another one was when I had first started voice lessons with Miss Kim and I was super nervous. But as the lessons went on and I became more and more relaxed. I still remember the first time I belted a big note. She was so proud of me and it was the best day ever. She really made me the singer that I am today. An equally impactful aha moment that I had was when I got my first lead role as Dorothy in The Wizard of Oz. I never really thought I was good enough, but once I got that role, I knew the teacher saw something in me even if I didn't. My personal favorite is when I got the Abuela in the Heights. I wanted that role, but I didn't think I was going to get her because I was so young. I was 12 at the time. I remember walking into the theater the next day and seeing that casting list with my name at the top of it. To be honest, I think I almost cried. I was so excited. I would like to give a huge thank you to Mr. Ricky for always pushing me to be my best, Ms. Kim for helping me through my ups and downs, Ms. Leah for always being so funny and cheering me up when I have a bad day, and good old Mr. Ryan for making me learn dance in a fun and less scary way. I also want to thank Ms. Carrie, Ms. Shelley, Mr. Jay, and especially Ms. Julie for all of the wonderful opportunities you've given me and my peers. You have taught us all how to be kind human beings and to have patience. Another group of people that have made me so spirited were my friends. They made the Malts a comfortable place to go without being judged. All of my peers are so supportive of each other and kind. This was the first place where I met people that were like me. I even met some of my best friends here, and I wouldn't give that up for anything. Clearly, the Malts Jupiter Theater Conservatory of Performing Arts has made a huge impact, not only on me, but my friends and family. Sincerely, me.
Our next award is the O'Hagan Family Award for Outstanding Improvement. This award is given to a student who has shown marked improvement in any one of the three disciplines, acting, voice, or dance. The student must show progress and regular attendance in class.
The O'Hagan Family Award for Outstanding Improvement, Zoe Zimmerman.
Hello, everyone. I'm so honored and thankful to be accepting this award. I took my first classes at the Malts when I was 5. I'm so grateful to have found a place like the Malts Theater to do what I love. Whether it's playing guitar with Miss Leah, singing with Mr. Ricky, or rehearsing for the next musical production, I know I can always have fun. I've also met some of my closest friends here. After a hard day at school, I can be myself and relax at the Malts. It's a creative outlet for me where I can express my feelings and act silly, all while learning valuable life lessons such as teamwork, confidence, and cooperation. I would like to thank Mr. Ricky, Miss Leah, Mr. Ryan, Miss Carrie, and of course, Miss Julie for helping me become a better performer and a better person. Thank you to my family who always support me, and especially my mom who is always there for me. During these uncertain times, it's encouraging to know that the Malts is one constant in our lives.
Our next award is the Dr. Bernard and Phyllis Eisenstein Cultural Award. This award is given to a student who is aware of the impact that their rich cultural heritage has had on the arts. This student shares their heritage with fellow students and the greater community and celebrates cultural differences.
The Dr. Bernard and Phyllis Eisenstein Cultural Award, Hannah Roberts.
I am honored to have received the Dr. Bernard and Phyllis Eisenstein Cultural Award. I've never really won an award before, so this speech may be a little bit wobbly. My culture has affected me in ways that I cannot begin to explain. It has given me so many layers, and my unique position has shaped who I am and how I perform. I'm half Japanese. I'm pretty sure that weighs in a lot for this award, but it goes deeper than just my DNA. I was born and raised in Florida, but every summer I go to visit my relatives in Japan. And even though I get to spend time in both of my cultures, I always feel like a part of me is missing. I've always felt unique and different from others, and not always in a positive way, but that made me a stronger individual. Art is a place where everyone can belong, and when I started theater, I finally felt like being different was good. Art has given me so much, and I want to continue utilizing my heritage to tell stories and share my culture with more people. I would like to thank all, especially Miss Julie, and Miss Leah, and of course my family, for supporting me. Thank you.
Our next award is the Jim and Diane Perella Unity Award. This award is presented to the student who continually strives to promote unity in all aspects of the classroom and performance. The student puts others first and demonstrates the notable moral qualities of selflessness and honor. They pull people together and are respected by their peers.
The Diane and James Perella Unity Award, Michelle Himes.
Hi, I'm Michelle Himes, and I'm so incredibly honored and humbled to accept the Diane and James Perella Unity Award. Thank you so much for this award. I am so honored. Thank you to Diane and James Perella for their continuous support toward the Conservatory of Performing Arts. Ever since I was 10, this has been my home away from home, and I'm so grateful to be a student there. When I was 10, I signed up for James and the Giant Peach Jr. over the summer. I came a day late and had never done a production like it before. The second I walked in the door, I was greeted by smiling faces and kind words. I immediately felt welcome. Then I met the fierce Mr. Ricky. For the past 3 years, Mr. Ricky has boosted my confidence, made me a better performer, and always gave me great advice. In March of 2018, I signed up for jazz because I loved it here so much. However, I couldn't take Jazz 1. Mr. Ricky let me sign up for Jazz 2, and it was such a fun class. I would always want to show my parents what we were learning, and I would always wish the class were longer. Now I'm in Jazz 3, and it stuns me every time I watch videos from previous routines and see the progress I've made in 2 years. And I couldn't have done it without Mr. Ricky's help. So thank you for being an amazing teacher. As months went by, I realized how much I loved Maltz, so over the summer, I started taking voice lessons with Miss Kim. Miss Kim has been such an incredible voice teacher, helping me with my technique, stage fright, and storytelling while singing. I'm so grateful to be able to learn from you, and I wish I could have more time. Next, I would like to thank Mr. J. Mr. J has helped me so much with not only dance, but with me as a person. If you know me well enough, you know I'm a perfectionist. I get mad if I don't do something well enough to my abilities, and I'm always striving to make things right. Mr. J has helped me find the difference between pushing myself and attacking my self-esteem. Dance is a form of art that is beautiful if you make it beautiful. If you beat yourself up, you will stop loving it and not look at it as an art. I started taking tap in August 2018, and I can't believe everything I've learned and the progress I've made. So thank you, Mr. J, for being such an incredible teacher. Next, I would like to thank Miss Leah for helping me with my acting skills and for helping me be a better person. You make shows so much fun, and it's a pleasure learning and working with you. Next, I would like to thank the incredible Mr. Bayan. Thank you for pushing me and overall just helping me become a better dancer. I don't know what I would be like without you. The next person I would like to thank is Miss Julie. Thank you for being a positive influence and thank you for keeping Maltz safe and unitized. Lastly, I would like to thank my family for their continuous support in me. You listen when I want to sing for you and you watch when I want to dance. You have shaped me to who I am today, and I couldn't express in a million words how grateful I am to have you. Thank you for driving me to all of my classes and events and everything else you do. So once again, I'm so incredibly grateful to be receiving this award and so happy to be a student at the Conservatory. Thank you.
Our next award is the Mary Ellen and Dermot Healy Award for Leadership. This award is given to a student who has inspired and motivated their fellow classmates, both in the studio and on stage. It is for a student who takes charge, makes decisions in the best interest of other cast members, and holds production values high.
The Mary Ellen and Dermot Healy Leadership Award, Brielle Cohen.
My name is Brielle Cohen, and I am the 2020 recipient of the Mary Ellen and Dermot Healy Leadership Award. When I found out I would be receiving this award, I asked myself the question, what makes a leader? In my experience, I have found that a leader is not someone that tells other people what to do, but rather provides opportunities. While I have found that being a leader in the classroom has been more than rewarding, the most joy that I have found being a leader is outside of the classroom. Fortunately, I have been able to plan events for my peers throughout the year. Whether it be a cast party or just being with friends between rehearsals, I feel so proud of the community that we at the Maltz Jupiter Theater have built. When I first started at the Conservatory, I knew nobody and I was extremely shy. So for me to be able to provide an opportunity for younger students to find friends and more importantly, find themselves, I feel so insanely happy. Just because we can't be together in person right now doesn't mean that the Conservatory has stopped having fun. Through our online classes, we've still been able to connect and create a community. and I've even organized a couple game nights for the cast of The Music Man too. So even though we can't be together eating key lime pie right now, I'm so happy that you all could be here virtually and we can celebrate all these wonderful students. Thank you.
Our next award is the Rick and Peggy Katz Award for Outstanding Achievement. This award is given to the student who has shown marked progress in all three disciplines, acting, dance, and voice. The student shows excellence in attendance, preparation, and maintains a positive attitude.
The Peggy and Rick Katz Award for Outstanding Improvement, Eamon Kimball.
Hi, I'm Eamon Kimball, and I'm honored to receive the Peggy and Rick Katz Award. Thank you to the Conservatory for choosing me. In the last few years, I've spent pretty much all of my time outside school, either at the Maltz or playing video games. Last summer, I was at the Maltz rehearsing pretty much every day. Until recently, I was there 3 or 4 days a week. I've learned a lot from the fantastic teachers there. Miss Carrie for voice, Miss Leah for acting, Miss Chrissy for improv, and Mr. Brian and Mr. Ricky for dance. I've progressed from small acting roles to much bigger roles, and I loved working with Miss Julie on her very own original play. And last summer's productions of In the Heights and Romeo and Juliet were so much fun. I could never have done these without your help and guidance. But most of all, the Conservatory is like a big second family for me. I've made many friends. I'm always at home there. Thank you again. I can't wait to get back on stage.
Our next award is the Paul and Sandra Goldner Award for Outstanding Commitment. This award is presented to the student who has shown outstanding collaboration and dedication to the theater. This student displays care, dedication, and a pay-it-forward attitude.
The Paul and Sandra Goldner Award for Outstanding Commitment, Chase Bauer.
My name is Chase Bauer, and I am proud to be the winner of the 2020 COPA Dedication Award. I would like to thank everyone at the Maltz Jupiter Theater, especially my teachers who made my first year so fun. I have learned that theater does not come easy and that you have to work hard. I believe that if you work hard, you can achieve anything. Maltz has also helped me become more social, too. Maltz has been a great way to make friends. I have had many friends through Maltz, and it has probably been one of the most exciting things I have ever done. All of the classes that I have done have paid off to get to this point when I can win the Dedication Award. I'd like to thank my family and friends for supporting me. When I got a lead role, I thought that the teachers would give me a chance. I wanted to dedicate myself so everyone could see that I could do it. I am honored to receive the 2020 COPA Dedication Award.
Our next award is the Julie Rowe Shining Star Award. This award is given to the student who is a true shining example of leadership. The student shows commitment to excellence and inspiration and expresses kindness and generosity of spirit.
The Julie Rowe Shining Star Award, Melanie McDonald.
Thank you so much for choosing me to be this year's recipient of the Julie Rowe Shining Star Award. During quarantine, I've realized how much I truly miss everyone at Maltz. Whether we were getting Marty's mic speech or stretching with Mr. Brian before a show, I was always having a good time. So I want to thank everyone at Maltz for helping me grow and discover my love for theater. I also want to thank my family for driving me to all the shows and practices and for tolerating my at-home practice. When I found out that I got the Julie Award, I was so excited. Miss Julie is such a good role model, and she's been kind to me since the day I started classes. She always makes sure that we look sharp for YTC shows and gives us home-baked treats during practices. I can't imagine Maltz without her. Maltz is a huge part of who I am. Maltz has taught me to not be afraid of public speaking, dance like nobody's watching, and embrace my differences. I can't thank Maltz enough for all that it has done for me. I'm looking forward to making so many more memories with all of these amazing people who have impacted my life so much. Thank you all.
And our final award is the Brian Andrews Award for Discipline. This award is given to a student who displays a positive attitude, an enviable work ethic, and is a role model to others. This student regularly goes above and beyond expectations. Their personal conduct exemplifies the meaning of discipline, and they are enrolled in ballet.
The Brian Andrews Award for Discipline, Aiden McDonald.
Good afternoon, everyone. If you're watching this, I'm probably dead. Well, I'm just kidding. I'm probably watching this back too and cringing at that attempt of a joke, so moving on. When I started attending the conservatory about a year and a half ago, I never thought I'd be standing here. Well, I usually do stand in my room, but not accepting one of these gracious awards. I truly am very honored and grateful to be receiving the Brian Andrews Award for Discipline today. I, of course, would like to thank the award's namesake, Brian Andrews, for selecting me to receive this award this year. Mr. Brian constantly pushes me to go the extra mile with our work and always raise the bar. Well, in this case, the ballet bar. A special thank you to all of my PTP instructors who never let me settle for good. Songs can always have higher stakes, monologues can have more beats, and combinations can always be done with a bigger smile. A warm thanks to my PTP team for their constant support and encouragement. Also, a thank you to Miss Julie for assembling this on Zoom and keeping the conservatory on its feet, always. But perhaps the biggest thank you belongs to my amazing parents. From day one, they have instilled in me a work ethic that I would not trade for the world. Mom, Dad, you have taught me to always work hard for what I want, for nothing comes free. Although they did pay for the suit that I'm wearing today. Anyway, I would also like to recognize this award's past recipients. It is humbling to be part of such an amazing group of recognized artists. Congratulations to the outstanding people also receiving awards today via Zoom. Although I do not work hard for the sake of receiving an award, it is absolutely wonderful and humbling to be recognized for it. Thank you again, and have a wonderful evening. And stay positive and strong in this dark time, for we'll go back into the light as soon as you know it.
Each season, the conservatory gets busier and busier. If it wasn't for our administrative team and amazing faculty, we would not be able to maintain our pace. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank each one of them for inspiring our students every single day. Thank you, students, for your amazing work, your dedication, your spirit, your joy, your tenacity, and your talents. And thank you for being a part of the COPA family. A big thanks to our sponsors, honorary producer, the Beebe Foundation, shining star sponsors, Roberta and Harvey Golub, Dr. James H. Howenstein, Marty and Bob Sachs, rising star sponsor, the Clark Family Private Foundation, Wish Upon a Star sponsors, Paul and Sandra Goldner, Jackie Cato and Howard Smith. And thank you so much for joining us today in celebration of our students' hard work and progress. Have a lovely weekend.